Hi, my name is Mike Mancini with PPCvideotraining.com. Thanks so much for joining us. Today, this video is going to be going along with our PPC Google Ads keyword spreadsheet. Now, why did we develop this spreadsheet? Because it helps us keep organized as far as when we're putting our campaigns together, keeping our ad groups and our keywords all in one spot so we can see how they're put together, what keywords are in what ad groups, and then also change the bids and the match types. And we get a little technical in it, but we show you how to do it in the video following this. And what it does is it helps you do it all in bulk. And then you literally take all of this and upload it in one mouse click up to Google using the AdWords editor. Once again, we will show you how to do all of that. It's rather simple. Down below in the description, there is a link where you can get the keyword spreadsheet for free. So feel free to do that. Also, if you like this tool or you like our videos, please subscribe to our channel or share it with someone who might find it valuable. And let's get started with the training. All right, so as you go through and you gather your keywords, you're gonna wanna put them all in one area, kind of compile a keyword list that makes it easy to upload them to Google when that time comes. So below this video, we have a link to an Excel spreadsheet that will look exactly like this. This is the tool that we use when we're compiling our keyword lists. You can do this easily in Google Documents as well, or any other type of software you want to do it, or however you want to sort it. This is just how we do it because it makes it quick and simple and easy to organize and sort and different things like that. So what we do is as we're going through, we take our keywords. Now, obviously this is for a heating and air conditioning company. These are the ones that we came up with that we might have put into Google or, you know, that we started out with. So we just put them under the keyword heading. Now, as we did a search through Google and through the other steps, Google came back with what's called ad groups, and then the keyword put into these ad groups. And as you can see, the furnace cleaning cost, cleaning furnace, these are all keywords that were put into this ad group by Google. So they're pretty tightly knit, meaning that we don't have furnace installation in the furnace cleaning ad group. All of these keywords have to do with furnace cleaning. And you can see as we scroll down, there's quite a few keywords and quite a few ad groups. Now we're going to be making ads for each one of these ad groups, but all of these keywords need to be in an ad group. So what I'm going to do is take a look at some of the different ones, furnace repair, furnace replacements. Now what I want you to do is take all of these keywords that do not have an ad group and put them in an ad group. Now if you don't find one that they might fit in, make one up. So maybe you don't have one that says air conditioner installation, and maybe that's the one that you come up with. But I want you to find the corresponding ad groups and go ahead and put them in there, put the correct ad group here. I'm gonna pause the video and do that now. All right, now what I want you to do is I want you to go up here and I want you to highlight both of these. And on Microsoft Excel, you can go up to data and you can sort. And I want you to sort them all by column A, which is the ad group. Sort by the values A to Z. All right, these are already sorted in alphabetical order. What I want you to do is go through and make sure that all of these are the same. So furnace cleaning is spelled the same way and is capitalized the same way. Let's show you an example. As you were going through, if you typed in furnace cleaning and furnace was not capitalized, but in the rest of these it is, Google will consider this and this different ad groups. So make sure that they're the same. It's just something that you can run into later that we're going to try and avoid. Doesn't matter if they're capitalized or not, as long as they all match. Now you can see this here as well. All of these keywords right here were furnace cost, just like they are right there. What we did was we went through and we want to keep our ad groups relatively small, meaning that our preference most of the time is to keep them 15 keywords or smaller. So if we have a bunch of keywords in one ad group, we will divide that ad group up and call it something different, maybe furnace cost 2. 15 keywords is a guideline. Some experts will say more, some will say less, but typically we usually keep them at 15 or under. And as we scroll down, we just make sure that they're all named the same thing. We got down here at the bottom and there's heating repair, and then there was a lot of them, so we kind of divided those up. And you can see we did the same for HVAC. All right, so we have our keyword list. What I want you to do is highlight both of these columns, copy them, and go down here to final keyword list, and I want you to paste them right here under add group and keyword. Now, you can name your campaign whatever you want. Maybe you want to name it 2017. Maybe you want to name it sales, whatever you want. We're just going to name our search, and we just put those there as a guideline. Make sure all of your ad groups and keywords have that next to it. So you can copy and paste those down, and you can see it's all the way down there. Go back up to the top. So over here in the keyword type column, we have it listed as phrase. Now, to give you an idea what the keyword types, Google has 5 keyword types. If you go down here to the bottom, there is a tab called types. Go ahead and click on that. We'll run you through it. So the type of keyword could be a broad match keyword, which means if your keyword is blue trucks and somebody in Google types this in, buy blue trucks, trucks that are blue, blue extended cabs, which is a synonym for trucks, your ad could show up. So once again, synonyms you can use. Instead of blue, it might be aqua, but it's very expansive group of keywords. We don't typically use it all that much unless we're doing research. The next keyword type is modified broad, which is listed like this with a plus sign. So what we're saying is it has to have these keywords somewhere in the search. So no synonyms. So if somebody types in buy blue trucks or trucks that are blue, then your ad could show up because it has those exact keywords, but in any order. So once again, the broad match we don't use too terribly much. But if we were to use a broad match, modified broad is the way to go because it's using the exact keywords. It's not listing in any synonyms. The next group is phrase match, which is the one we use the most of. And what that means is it has to be in the exact order. So if somebody types in blue trucks, our ads could show up. If somebody types in buy blue trucks, the best blue trucks for sale, it's got blue trucks exactly how we typed it in that order, but it allows for keywords before and after. The next one is exact match. Now, exact match is exactly what it sounds like. If somebody types in blue trucks, our ad will only show up if they type in just that keyword and just that keyword alone. Nothing before, nothing after, just blue trucks. That's the only time our ad will show. It is the most restrictive keyword type, so it won't get a ton of impressions, but if that's exactly what you're going after and you want no variation whatsoever, then that might be the way to go. But typically we will leave a little bit of wiggle room, which is why we use phrase match. Now, Google has stated that 20% of all searches are keywords that nobody has typed in before. We want to leave a little bit of leeway there. The last group is negative. Now, negative keywords are where we don't want our ads to show up. So if somebody, maybe our negative keywords are free, cheap, inexpensive. If somebody types in cheap blue trucks, our ads will not show. If they type in blue trucks that are cheap, if that negative keyword cheap is anywhere in that keyword search, Google will not show our ads. And those are very, very important to have as well. So let's get back to the final keyword list. We typically start with phrase, but you can do whatever you want. As you can see over here, we have listed how they get typed in with the plus symbols and the brackets and everything. You don't have to worry about that because we're telling Google right here what keyword type we want to use. So we're just going to use phrase. You need to have that next to all of them. And then a maximum cost per click. We don't know exactly what it's going to cost, but we want to put the maximum amount we're going to allow, at least initially, for our ads to run. Maybe it's 2, 3, 4. You need to remember that these are going to be adjusted later, but if you don't bid high enough, your ads will not even show up. So typically we will start these around $3 or $4. You can put whatever you want, but maybe just because you're starting out, let's just split the difference and we'll go, let's say $2.50. All you have to put in is 2.5. You don't have to worry about the dollar sign or anything. copy that all the way down and paste it. Now, we're going to click over to negative keywords. Right here, we're just going to make a list of keywords that we don't want our ads to show up if anybody types this in. So we might say free is always one that you want to put there, especially if you're selling services. Free, cheap, inexpensive. Maybe we're a heating and air conditioning company, just residential. Maybe we do not do commercial work. So in here, you would put commercial. You don't have to type a ton in here, but these are just a few to get an idea. I would always add in free, cheap, inexpensive, different things like that. If you don't do any deals, type in deals, whatever it might be. But I would always at least put these in there to kind of exclude the people that are looking for basically, a free lunch. And once you're done with that, you now have your keyword list complete. All right, this video is going to be how to upload your keywords and your ads to Google AdWords by using AdWords Editor. We told you before, the reason that we use AdWords Editor is because of the speed that we can do all of this. We don't have to do ads one at a time and upload them that way. We don't have to type in the individual keywords. We can literally copy and paste. So when you open up AdWords Editor, you're going to see this. You're going to see your account here. Click on it to open it up. Obviously, we're going to black these out because these are some of our clients. We set up a test campaign, but click on the account that you want to upload your ads to and your keywords. All right, we actually called this our testing account. So when we set this up, we had just a dummy campaign in here. We just called it campaign number one. It doesn't have any keywords or ads or anything like that. So if you want to get rid of it just to get it out of the way, you can click on it and you can click on remove. Now it will remove this after a period of time. Nothing you have to worry about right now. But what we want to do is we want to upload our keywords and we want to upload our ads. So let's go to our keyword sheet. And here we have our final keyword list, and you can see we have campaign name, ad group, keyword, keyword type, and then the maximum cost per click. You can change all of this later. It's not a big deal right now. But what we want to do is we want to go and we want to highlight all of this, including the headers. So you want to highlight all of it and click on copy. Go back to Google AdWords Editor. Go down here and click on this little arrow next to keywords and targeting and go to keywords. Click on keywords, then go up here and click on make multiple changes. Now we copied our headers so we don't have to go and enter anything in here. So make sure that it says my data headers. My data includes columns for campaigns and or ad groups. Make sure that's checked. Click right there and then you can paste everything. You can just click paste from clipboard. As you can see, because we copied our headers in here, it automatically fills them in. Go down here to the bottom right and click on process. You can see it added our campaign, which was search is what we were calling it. It added 29 ad groups, so it added all these ad groups, and it added 213 keywords, which is correct because it says 214, but the header counts as one. So 213 keywords, which is right. Go ahead and click on finish and review changes. Now it says a status pending review. Google will approve all of the keywords and ads and everything before they actually let it go. Now you can see we have an error here. So you can go to campaigns, click on that. The error is highlighted by the red exclamation point. And you can click on where the error is and it will tell you down here. It says your daily budget is invalid. Change your daily budget to be a positive value. So basically we just don't have a daily budget. So you can go right over here and for right now, we're just gonna say $1. That's all we're gonna do. We'll mess with this later. I'll show you something else to do. But the error is gone. Now, once you're done with your keywords, you will normally upload your ads, but we kept that for a separate video because we have a different tool that we use to help craft our ads. And down below in the description, you should find a link to our Google expanded text ads generator. It's a spreadsheet that we put together that helps us craft multiple ads per ad group. And once again, we just upload them all at once right to Google during this process. But in this particular process, what we're doing is we just uploaded our keywords. Keep continuing to watch the video. We'll show you how to post those. But typically right after we would upload our keywords, we would upload our ads and then it would all be done. But just wanted to give you a heads up. We're just uploading our keywords right now at this time. So make sure that you watch the rest of the video so you know exactly what you should do as far as making sure your account is paused, so on and so forth. Okay, here we go. Once you're done with all that and all the warnings are gone and there's no errors or anything like that, you can click on post. This will come up and it will say post the changes to, post all changes, or just the selected campaign. We can just post all the changes, click on post. I'm not going to do that because this is a test campaign right now. All right, now real quick, before you hit the post button to make all of these ads active, remember, we just uploaded a new campaign, right? It was a campaign that was not in the system yet. So when we upload this stuff, it's going to be live. Before we do that, let's go in here and we want to pause that campaign. So go up to search, click on it, and highlight it. And that will highlight the entire campaign. You must highlight the entire campaign, otherwise you will only pause a single ad group. Then to pause all the campaigns, you can go up here and you can click on the green button. And you can go down to pause, or you can just highlight that, and then down here, right here, it's under status, you can click on enable or pause. So until we're ready to go, make sure that that is paused. You know, once right before we launch it, we'll go through and double check all the settings and make sure it's ready to go. But right now, let's keep that on pause. Another thing, but so we don't forget this, we don't want display ads. We want search network only. Make sure you change that as well. Everything else should be okay for now. We will review it before we launch the campaign. Thanks so much for watching our video. If you enjoyed it, please like or subscribe to our channel or share our video with someone who might find it interesting. Or if you know someone who is in need of PPC or Google Ads services, please forward our information to them. We'd love to help. Thanks so much.